Hi, Leah. I got into the music industry when I was about 12 years old. I was singing with Mitya for years, and basically she was in the studio recording solo stuff, and one day she said to me, do you want to come to the studio with me? I ended up coming. I was reading a magazine, minding my own business, and then I got asked if I could sing. I was like, a little bit, and they were like, can you sing something together? And I think we sang some SWV, and I started recording with her and Siobhan, and from there went on to get our first record deal. And we were very, very young, and I'm glad I did it for the experience. I'm looking forward to going on tour next year, just because being on tour and performing is one of my favourite things to do, as well as being in the studio. And I love the fact that, you know, when we're performing, we get to see our fans singing along, and really we'll sing the songs that we've written as well, especially when you've written a song that's close to you and someone else is singing it, and you just know that you've touched that person. It's the best feeling ever. And also, I miss being on tour because of the costume changes that we did running backstage, and also the dinners as well, because we have our own like chef backstage, which is very, very cool. And so we get to order anything we want, and that's always quite fun.
I'm Lel. From a very young age, I've always known that I wanted to entertain people, and I love to sing. I used to do shows like to my whole family, make them all sit down and perform to them. I've just always had in my head that I couldn't imagine myself doing anything else, so I've worked very hard and for a long time to get to where I am now, and absolutely love it, you know. I love being in the band. And what was the other question? What's the best thing in the Burma? Yeah, and the best thing about being in a girl band is, I don't know, I think being like a solo artist sometimes, me and the girls sometimes say this when we're doing interviews, like, or we're travelling around, like, it must be quite lonely, you know, being on your own a lot. But, you know, you've got two friends that you work with and that share the same dream as you and travel around together. You stay in each other's room sometimes when you're lonely. So it's just like having two mates with you all the time, and we just have a lot of fun performing together and just experiencing this together as well. So, yeah.
Hi Sarah, the advice that I would give to somebody trying to make it in the music industry would be to believe in yourself. I think, you know, a lot of people get many knockbacks, and I know I did, and I know Mal did too. And, you know, the main thing was that we believed in ourselves. And I think another important thing is to not just expect it to come to you. You've got to push yourself. You've got to go out there and try and keep trying and looking for opportunities. The best of luck. You can't look, but you
can't touch. Silly boy. Hi Jane, if I wasn't in the Sugar Babes, I couldn't imagine myself doing anything else. I've always been a bit of a drama queen, newsflash, and I would probably do something to do with, I'd probably do a bit of acting maybe, but I couldn't really imagine myself not being on stage, and I just love it, so I couldn't imagine myself doing anything else. Hi Jay, my favourite track from our new album, well, I love every single one of them, but one of the tracks that I love was a song that Neo wrote for us called No More You. And the reason why I like this song is just because I can really relate to it. It's that, you know, relationship song that every single girl can kind of listen to and go, yeah, I've been through that before. And I'm also a big fan of Neo's, so I was very excited when I knew that we were working with him.
Hi Karen, I don't know whether we actually need a fourth member, to be honest. We're just very happy as we are as a three, and so I think three is enough to definitely in this band. Thank you.
Hi, MZ. My influences growing up were a group called SWV, vocally, Brandy. I loved Boyz II Men. It was more so for my vocal side, like early R&B. Also, but for influences as far as like my personal life, I'd say my mum straight away. I don't mind turning out like her. I think she's such a humble and lovely and meek lady, completely opposite to me. Like, I'm like this firecracker and she's so calm, and she's definitely given me you know, the, she's really believed in me and given me that drive, I guess, and in some ways, a lot of ways, she's really helped me with my faith and things like that. So my mum. Hi, Leanne. The next big thing that we want to achieve for Sugar Babes is to break new territories. And so many people say to us, God, you've achieved so much, and what else is there left to do? But there's so much things that we want to do. You know, we haven't broken, you know, places like Japan and America, and that's something that we'd really love to do. And just, you know, continue to sell more records, because you can never sell enough. And also to be happy.
Hello, Debs. If I could be invisible for a day, I don't know, I think I'd be really nosy. I think I'd go into like people's houses and like perving on them, but I'd just go in and listen to conversations. I'd go in and see what Jude Law and this other woman was saying about the arrival of the new baby. I don't know, loads of gossip. I'd go into so many people's houses and have a look at what they've got to say for themselves. What else would I do? Oh, go on loads of holidays, jump on a flight. Well, what you can do in one day, jump on a flight basically, go to a lovely hot country, nick loads of food, go to a restaurant. I'd do so many things if I was invisible. So that'll be a few of many anyway.
Hi, Lindsay. Songs that I wish were our own. I think we've done a collaboration of On Vogue's Don't Let Go, and I'm sure we wish that we'd had that song. Or I remember when Don't You by the Pussycat Dolls first got played to us, and we were so gutted. We were like, that is such a good song. Like, we really wish that we'd been given that song. Also, Sex on Fire, even though it probably wouldn't go well as a Sugar Babe song, I just am obsessed with that song at the moment, so maybe that one.